In today's video, I'm going to show you the only four steps you need to take to route audio from Ableton or any other DAW into Zoom, as well as the one mistake I made the first time I did this and how you can avoid it. Brett Pontecorvo here at livekeyboardist.com, where I help keyboard players just like you with the ins and outs of sound design, with building a stable live keyboard rig, and with mastering Ableton. If you're new here, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. All right, so in the current times, many more people are having to perform through a digital platform, and using a program called BlackHole, we can really easily send our audio from any DAW into Zoom. So here's how it's done. First, you're going to navigate over here to existential.audio/blackhole, and you're going to fill in your information here and click subscribe for free Mac download. This is going to show up in your email address and give you all of the instructions that you need to install BlackHole. Once it's installed, make sure that you restart your computer. Step number two, we need to create a multi-output device, which can really quickly be done through audio settings. So I'm going to navigate there using Alfred, which is my favorite navigator, but you can also do this using Spotlight. And we'll create it really quickly by hitting this plus button. Create multi-output device. And now we just need to choose which devices should be included. So I'm going to pick Sapphire because that is my audio interface, and I'm going to pick BlackHole. Now, the one thing I forgot to do the first time that did not go well with me is I did not check this drift correction box for BlackHole 16 channel. If you don't do that, you're going to get some crazy sounds. So make sure you check that box. And while we're at it, why don't you let me know in the comments below where you're planning on sending your audio from? I know I often send mine to Zoom when I'm teaching piano lessons or Ableton coachings, which, by the way, if you would like a piano lesson or an Ableton coaching, make sure you click that link below to schedule a time with me. All right, so moving right along to step number three, we need to set up our DAW to send audio to the correct places. So I'm going to open up Ableton right now, again, using Alfred, and we're going to navigate to our preferences, which you can do quickly by hitting Command comma. Now, for our audio output device, we are going to choose our multi-output. This is going to allow us to send audio both to our monitors or to our audio interface, as well as to Zoom. And for our audio input device, we are going to choose our audio interface or whatever you're going to be using to capture your sound. At this point, although we can't see it, audio is flowing. So here's my piano sound, and I'm going to set up a channel strip for my microphone. So we'll do external input, and I'm going to choose channel 1, because that is the channel that my microphone is on. And I'm going to disable this for now so we don't get any crazy feedback, but I am going to demo this for you in just a second. We are on to our final step, which is to set our Zoom settings. So here we are in Zoom. I'm just going to click this little wheel here. We'll choose audio. And for our microphone, we are going to choose BlackHole 16 channel. So when I play keys, you'll see that Zoom is picking it up. And I'm going to go ahead and turn my mic on here so you can hear that it's also picking me up as well. Check, check, check. And here's an actual recording of the audio quality that I'm getting inside of Zoom. This is me checking the audio quality of BlackHole. Now, if you like any of the sounds that you're hearing, I've got videos up on the screen that talk about the ones that I love to use the most. And if you got value out of this video, please consider hitting that like and subscribe button. And I will see you next time on Live Keyboardists.